isn't it? So regression and the problem that we have given in the last class, everybody can listen to me and hear me.
Yes, sir.
Question number 5, we have this arithmetic mean of x and y are given, that is 10 and 35. Standard deviation is 2 and 5, and value of r is given. So, and obtain the regression. Can you find out the regression equations? Can you find out the regression equations? So, can you find out regression line of y on x? Y on x, can you find out?
Yes, sir.
Please quickly, y on x and x on y. So y on x is, we'll be using this formula, y minus y bar equals to m into x minus x bar. Here, how to find out m? What is the formula for m? We have calculated yesterday, r into sigma y by
Sigma X.
x. Now value of r is given. What is the value of r?
Zero
Point
point eight.
0.8,
Zero point
0.8,
eight.
and sigma y is 5. Standard deviation is sigma. Sigma y is 5 and sigma x is 2.
Two.
So calculate, so that means the value of r is, sorry, m is 0.4 into 5 is equals to how much? 0.4 into 5, that is 2. That is 2, yes. So put it in the equation. So what we get? We get y minus y bar is, how much is y bar? Arithmetic mean is y bar, that is 35. Y minus 35 is equals to, we have already found out m as 2, x minus 2. So that is the regression line of y on x. And regression line of x on y, similarly find
Sir,
out.
X bar will be 10.
Yes,
Yes,
x bar
sir.
will be 10.
X bar will be
Right,
10.
x bar will be 10. Right, I have made a mistake. Right. And quickly find out x on y regression. X on y quickly, similarly. So in that case, m dash equals to r into sigma x by sigma y. So that is 0.8 into sigma x is 2 and sigma y is 5. So the value of, how much is that? So 0.8 into 2 divided by 5, that is equals to 0.32.
0.32.
0.32. So your regression line will be x minus x bar, that is 10. X minus x bar is equals to 0.32 y minus y bar. Y bar is 35. Y minus 35. So that is the regression line of x on y. Now obtain the regression equation of amount demanded on price and estimate the likely demand when price is given. So here price is given, that means here price is given x equals to how much? 12.5. So we have to find out the value of y. So that means we have to put this value of x in which equation? Where to put? This equation or the previous one?
Previous one.
Yes, previous one. Yes, previous one. Regression line of y on x. So that means y minus y bar was 35 is equals to 2 into x equals to 12.5 minus 10. So please calculate. So that means y equals to 40. Isn't it? Calculate quickly. let us solve question number 9, where it is given that variance of x is equals to 36 and the two regression lines equations are given as 12x minus 15y plus 99 equals to 0 and 60x plus minus 27y equals to 321. So please write a question. I'll add 2-3 more questions. Please add, write down this question. Identify which is the regression line of y on x and which is x on y. So that is the first question. Identify which one is x on y and which one is y on x. That's the first question. Second question is find the average value of x and y. So find x bar and y bar. Then find the value of r. And what is the standard deviation of y. So you have to find all this. So you have to find out standard deviation of y. So you have to find out this. But before doing that, you have to identify which one is the regression line of y on x and which one is the regression line of x on y. Now, this is very, very important. Identification is very important. So let's do that. Okay. So please write along with me. I am also writing. So what we'll assume, we'll write let 12x minus 15y plus 99 equals to 0 is a regression line of, let us assume 12x minus 15y plus 99 equals to 0 is the regression line of y on x. So we are assuming this, the first equation as the regression line of y on x. So if it is regression line of y on x, then we will try to write this as in that particular form. So that means we will write minus 15y equals to minus 12x minus 99, or y equals to 12 by 15x plus 99 by 15. Is it okay? So I am taking the keeping y, because we have written y is equals to mx plus c. So I am trying to write this in that particular form. So that's why I have written minus 15y is equals to, so I have taken all other things to the other side of equality. So this gives m equals to 12 by 15. That is 4 by 5. Isn't it? Is it okay? Now similarly for the second equation we have 60x minus 27y equals to 321. So we will write down this as regression line of x on y. So that means we'll try to keep x in this side and 27y plus 321. So what we get is x equals to 27 by 60 y plus 321 by 60. So comparing with x equals to m dashed y plus c dashed, what we get is m dashed equals to how much? M dashed equals to
27 by 60.
That is, if this is 9 by 20. So if you cancel 3, numerator and denominator, so this will become 39 is 27 and 320. So what we have seen, that m dash equals to 9 by 20 and m equals to how much we have got? 4 by 5, na?
4
by 5.
Yes,
so,
sir.
So now that was our assumption. Now, so we have last day we have written that m into m dashed. So if I multiply m into m dash, how much I'll get? M into m dash is equals to 4 by 5 into 9 by 20. That gives you 0.36, isn't it? 36 by 100.
100, yes sir.
And we have already seen that m into m dash is equals to r square, and r square lies between how much?
0 to 1.
And by this assumption, here our r square is 0.36, which lies between 0 to 1. That means our assumption is correct. That means our assumption is correct, because here we have achieved r square as 0.36, which lies between 0 to 1. Hence our assumption is correct. So we have identified which one is the equation line of y on x and which one is x on y. Now I'll just try to explain a little bit more. So previously we have assumed 60x minus 27y equals to 321 as regression line of x on y, or we can write we have assumed 12x minus 15y plus 99 equals to 0. So we have assumed previously this as y on x. That's what we have assumed. Now let's check, if we assume this as x on y, then what happens? Then what happens? If this is x on y, then we will write in the form of x on y. Then we will write this as in the form of x on y. So what will happen? So 12x equals to 15y minus 99. That means x equals to 15 by 12 y minus 99 by 12. So that means we get m dashed as 15 by 12, that is 5 by 4, okay? 5 by 4?
Yes, sir.
And similarly, the second one, 60x minus 27y is equals to 321. This will be assuming as y on x. So we'll be writing y this side, that means minus 27y is equals to minus 60x plus 321. So that means y equals to, we are dividing by minus 27, this becomes 60 by 27x minus 321 by 27. So that means what we get, m equals to, what we get, tell me, m equals to 60 by 27. That means 20 by
9.
So if we multiply m into m dashed, they are of same sign, so no problem. M into m dashed, what we get is 20 by 9 into 5 by
5 by 4.
That means 100 by 36, which is greater than 1. 100 by 36 is greater than 1, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
So which is not possible, because we know that r square lies between 0 and 1. So if somebody assumed that 12x minus 15y plus 99 equals to 0, this is, if somebody assumes this is x on y, he would have got to a wrong result. He would have got to a relation that r square is, then he would have got to a relation r square is greater than 1, and which is not acceptable. So then we would have said that our assumption is wrong, so it has to be the other way around. So this is how we identify the regression line, which one is regression line. We have identified that 12x minus 15y plus 99 equals to 0 is key y on x. Na? This is y on x, and 60x minus 27y equals to 321 is x on y. So we have already found out r square, how much we have got? R square we have got as 0.36. So that means yes. r equals to plus minus 0.6. So when you square root plus 0.6 and minus 0.6, both of them are possible. Now please write, as both m and m dash are positive, r will also be positive. So we'll take the positive value. So we'll be taking r is equals to plus 0.6 and we'll ignore minus 0.6. Both m and m dash are positive, then r will be positive. If both m and m dash are negative, then r will be negative. So that is the way of finding the value of r. Okay. Now you
can see that ekta positive ar ekta negative ke hote pare m m dhorun positive berlo m dash jodi negative bere sorokom ki hote pare
দুটো একটা পজিটিভ একটা নেগেটিভ হলে দে আর মাল্টিপ্লাই ইফ ইউ মাল্টিপ্লাইং আ পজিটিভ নাম্বার উইথ আ নেগেটিভ নাম্বার দ্য ভ্যালু উইল বি নেগেটিভ
আচ্ছা
সো দ্যাট r স্কয়ার ক্যানট বি নেগেটিভ ইট ক্যানট বি নেগেটিভ সো দ্যাট উইল নট বি দ্য কেস ইট ইজ ইম্পসিবল ইট উইল নট বি দ্য কেস ইট ক্যানট বি বোথ অফ দেম আইদার বোথ অফ দেম উইল বি পজিটিভ অর বোথ অফ দেম উইল বি নেগেটিভ ইফ বোথ m এন্ড m ড্যাশ আর পজিটিভ দেন r উইল বি পজিটিভ ইফ বোথ m এন্ড m ড্যাশ আর নেগেটিভ দেন r উইল বি নেগেটিভ If both m and m dash is negative, then if you multiply it, r square will be positive, isn't it? If you multiply, that we have discussed in the last class also. So we have found out r. Now how to find out x bar and y bar? Who can tell me? How to find out x bar and y bar? That's the other part. How to find out x bar and y bar? Kya bolte pare? We have said yesterday's class properties. I said both the regression line pass through x bar, y bar. So that means you have to solve the two regression equation to find x bar, y bar. So quickly solve it. Quickly solve the two regression equation to find the value of x bar and y bar. Quickly solve. So we are solving these two equations. So solving these two regression lines, we can get the value of x bar and y bar. We get the value of y bar as 17. So y bar is 17, and if you put it in the 12x equals to 15 into 17 minus 99. That is that gives you 15 into 17 minus 99 equals to
13, sir, x equals to
divided by 12 is equals to 13, right? So 156. That means x equals to 12. So that means what will
13?
Oh, sorry, 13, right? X bar equals to 13. So that means both the regression line pass through the point 13 comma 17. So that means the value of x bar is 13 and the value of y bar is 17. And what we are left with? We are left with to find out the value of sigma y. How to find out the value of sigma y? We know the value of m equals to r sigma y by sigma x. So all the values are given. What is the value of m we have found out? M we have found out as 4 by 5, na?
Yes, sir.
M 4 by 5, r is 6 by 10. 0.6, r is 0.6, is 6 by 10. Sigma y, we have to find out. Sigma x is given. What is sigma x? Who can tell me what is the value of sigma x? Given that variance of x is 36. Given that variance of x is 36.
6, it will be 6.
Sigma x equals 6, right? So calculate. So sigma y equals to 8. Sigma y will be 8. Simply put the values there, you will get it. I don't think I need to teach you. M is 4 by 5, R is 6 by 10, sigma x is 6. Just put the values, you will get sigma y as 6, 6 cancels out, this 5 and 10 cancels out, this 2 and 4 is cross multiplied.
Eight.
Huh? Sigma y as 8.
Eight.
Now this is a new problem. Please write this problem. While calculating the correlation coefficient of a set of 10 values.
Sir, please repeat.
While calculating the correlation coefficient for set of 10 values, was for a set of 10 pairs of values, a student has copied a pair of data wrongly. A student has copied a pair of data wrongly as 36, 79 instead of 46, sorry, instead of 46 and 76. So what the student has done? So what he has written? He has written 36 in place of 46 as X and written 79 in place of 76 as Y. So he has written this value wrong. This is the correct value. This is the wrong value. So only one pair he has written it wrongly. Only one pair he has written it wrongly. And thus he has obtained the correlation coefficient R as 0.83 and X bar as 62.5, Y bar as 73.8, standard deviation of X as 10.87 and standard deviation of Y as 9.72. So I am again repeating the values. So what he has done? So he has done while writing the 10 pairs of data, he has copied one pair wrongly. He has 10 pairs of values. Right? He has 10 pairs of values and he has written one pair as wrongly as 36,79 instead of 46,76, and thus he has got the values of R as 0.83, X bar as 62.5, Y bar as 73.8, sigma X, standard deviation of X as 10.87, and standard deviation of Y as 9.72. So what you have to do, you have to correct all the values. You have to correct. Please make necessary corrections. Please make necessary corrections. So that is the problem. So we know that X bar, what is the definition of X bar? X bar is summation xi by n, isn't it? Now, what is the wrong value of X bar here in this case? So wrong X bar is how much?
36.
No.
Sir, 36.
X bar, wrong X bar is 62.5.
62.5.
So
So we can write that wrong. That means 62.5 equals to summation xi by 10, because there are 10 sets of values. So that means wrong summation xi equals to 625, because 62.5 into 10. Is it okay?
Yes, sir.
So wrong summation xi is 625. So correct summation xi equals to ki hobe? Who can tell me? Correct summation xi will be 625. Haan, bolo, bolo.
625 plus 46 plus 76.
No, 625 minus 36 plus 46. Correct y bar as 73.5, and we have to also find out the correct standard deviation of x. So what is the formula for standard deviation of x? Is root over summation xi square by n minus x bar square, isn't it? So that is the formula for standard deviation of x.
Yes, sir.
Now, because there was a wrong value initially, so this 10.87 is also wrong. So 10.87 is equals to root over of.
Sir, we can also calculate.
Yes, calculate. Just calculate. Do along with me. Summation xi square by 10 minus initially x bar was 62.5, because you have used all the wrong values, that's why you have got all the wrong values. So we can write this as 10.87 equals to root over of summation xi square by 10 minus, what was the wrong, it was 62.5 whole square. So from here, can you calculate what is the wrong value of summation xi square? So can you do that quickly? Do that. We will take two places of decimal, because the values are given in terms of two places of decimal. So what we get is 40244.07. So can you similarly calculate wrong value of So after we get wrong value of summation xi square, we will make correct value of, we will calculate correct value of summation xi square. How can we do that? How can we do correct value of summation xi square? So this is
A value 4, minus 36 square.
Minus 30, very good. Minus 36 square. Plus 46 square. Plus 46 square. So just do that. 40244 minus 36 square plus 46. Yes, you can omit that 0.07 part. You may not omit that. So please calculate. So minus 36 square plus 46 square. What we get is 41064. What we get is 41064.07. Isn't it? So summation, corrected value of correct summation xi square we get as 41064.07. X bar we have got is correct x bar we have got is, Tell me correct, 63.5, and correct,
yes,
correct y bar we have got is 73.5. So similarly you find out correct value of summation yi square. So similarly you will find out correct value of summation yi square. Please, so so correct value of summation yi square find out. So for that, what we have to do is we have to use, this is 9.72 is equals to root over of summation yi square by 10 minus 73.8 square. So from here we'll be getting wrong value of summation yi square. So quickly do that. Quickly do that. Correct value, correct value of summation yi square. What I have got is 54944. 0.18.
Sir, 54093.87.
No, I think 73.8 was, I think mine is right. Omlan koto pachho dekho to.
Five four nine double four point one eight.
It is right. I think this is the correct value of kichu ekta calculation mistake 9.72 square kore tar shonge 73.8 square ta add kore then we have to multiply by 10.
Sir apnar pointer value 18 esheche
ha 18
aur 20 esheche
oh yeah 18 and 20 modhe there is no difference. So correct value of summation yi square equals to 54944.18. And also then we have to calculate for R what you require. For R you require correct value of summation xi yi. So correct value of summation xi yi, how to get it? So we require for correct value of summation xi yi, we need correct value of summation xi yi. So for that I should have been given a wrong value of summation xi yi. I should have been given. So for that let's so wrong value of xi yi is না সেটাও পাওয়া যাবে অ্যাকচুয়ালি ডোন্ট নিড টু ক্যালকুলেট উই ক্যান ফাইন্ড আউট দ্যাট সো টু ক্যালকুলেট দ্য রং ভ্যালু অফ সামেশন এক্স আই ওয়াই আই উই হ্যাভ টু ইউজ দ্য ফর্মুলা ফর আর সো ইফ উই পুট দ্য ভ্যালুজ হিয়ার উই গেট অল দ্য রং ভ্যালুজ উই হ্যাভ পুট সো ক্যালকুলেট দ্য ভ্যালু অফ রং ভ্যালু অফ সামেশন এক্স আই ওয়াই আই সো 0.83 ইন্টু 10.87 ইন্টু 9.72 is equals to plus 62.5 into 73.8 is equals to into 10. So what we get is 47001.95. So the wrong value of summation xi yi, this is wrong value. What we get is 47001.95. I have got 948.948, so it will be like that. So to get correct value of so how much I have said 47001.95. So correct value, correct summation xi yi equals to 47001.95 minus, so minus, bolo minus, minus 36 into 79 plus
46 into 76.
Right. So calculate. So minus 36 into 79 plus 46 into 76. So what we get is 47653. 47653.95. 47653.95. So correct value of summation is equals to 47653. So now to get the correct value of R, we just put all the correct values. Now put all the
correct of summation X, I, Y, I, key value. Oh
yeah, 47653.95. I have already written the expression. Wrong ta theke wrong value product ta ke baad dilam because x I into y I, so wrong x I y I chilo 36 at 79, so I have just multiplied that. X I into y I means x into y, so that's what I have done. So wrong value product ta ke multiply kore subtract kurna and added the correct values product.
আমার স্যার ওই একই জিনিস করেছে, আমার ক্যালকুলেশন 5352.90.
না ক্যালকুলেশন কি করে হবে মাইনাস তুমি কি ইয়ে ইউজ করছো?
না স্যার ক্যালকুলেটর ইউজ করছো।
কোন ক্যালকুলেটর ইউজ করছো?
ওই ক্যাসিওর মানে সায়েন্টিফিক ক্যালকুলেটর।
সায়েন্টিফিক ক্যালকুলেটরে করলে ওরকম কিছুতেই হতে পারে না। সায়েন্টিফিক ক্যালকুলেটরে আমিও তো সায়েন্টিফিক ক্যালকুলেটর ইউজ করেছি। কত প্রান্ত কত আছে বলো
স্যার? আমার তো 47653.9
এটাই হবে।
এটাই হচ্ছে স্যার, দেখছি আমি তাহলে
সাইনে কিছু গন্ডগোল করেছো। ওকে, সো নাও টু ক্যালকুলেট দা কারেক্ট ভ্যালু অফ আর, সো উইল জাস্ট ইউজ দা কারেক্ট অল দা কারেক্ট ভ্যালুস, সো দ্যাট মিন্স ইট উইল বি 47653/10 মাইনাস আচ্ছা 47653 পয়েন্ট কত ছিল জানো?
95.95
সো আর প্লিজ ক্যালকুলেট, সো 47653.95/10 মাইনাস বলো
63.5 × 73.5
রাইট 63.5 into, we'll be using all the correct values now, 73.5 divided by square root of, oh we have already obtained the standard correct, oh correct y y square korle hi hobe, so correct x xi square how much?
Correct xi
41064.07 0.07/10 minus 63.5 square এটা একটা into root over, I don't have much space in my board, so please correct yi square is 54944.18. I don't have much space, so please you people can carry on. 54944.18. I'm not getting space to write. 54944.18/10 our correct expression for R will be this. So calculate. So what we get is the numerator we get as 47653.95 minus, and so on the numerator we get 47653.95 minus 63.5 into
70.5. So 1.210.
Just a second. So in the numerator, numerator 98.145. Okay. and the denominator we get just square root of square root of what we get is 4106.407 minus 63.5 square. That is so root over this is 74.157
7 92.168.
Just a second, I'm also trying to move. So that part becomes 5494.418 minus 73.5 square. So that gives you 92.168, na?
Uh-huh.
0.168 into 74.157
equals to
square root answer
equals to. Denominator sir
82.6. Please. 98.145 is equals to 1.18
হয়ে গেছে তাই তো হ্যাঁ এটাই
আসছে স্যার না एक्चुअली 1.18 হবে না
স্যার 1.654
নো
আমার স্যার 1.210 আছে স্যার
আমার না 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 প্লিজ প্লিজ লিসেন লিসেন উই গট 1.18 বাট দ্যাট ইজ রং হোয়াই Who can tell me why?
Because the value of
R lies between
minus 0 and 1.
Yes.
Minus one plus
one. R lies between minus 1 and plus 1. So actually, that what we have done is the process is okay. Process is right. Because I have given the data. I have made the data yes, myself. So that's why the calculation is coming like that. Okay. But the process is absolutely okay. Whatever we have done. Process is absolutely okay. Because of the data that I have given, because of the data it came like that. There is nothing wrong in the process. This is how you have to proceed and calculate. Actually, it should have been the better data should have been given. But here, because of the data discrepancy, we have got something like that. But the process is absolutely right. This is how you have to do to calculate R. Because all other values we have got all corrected values and now we should have put it correctly so to get this result okay